I'm Sanchit Sethi and I'm from Gurgaon, Haryana. I'm 18 years old and I like to read, I like to play the guitar and I like to play basketball. I had a lot of influences growing up. I guess I read a lot of John Grisham books and one of my particular favorite was A Time to Kill. It was also adapted into a movie, I guess. And I did some Moral United Nations and school competitions about parliamentary law. And I understood that how rule and order really regulated society to the very core in such a manner that every legal case that we see is actually gives out the rights and liabilities of each and everyone and dictates the way we live. So I found it pretty fascinating as to how such a simple thing could control almost every aspect of our lives. And that had a profound influence on me. The LSAT India exam was a very pleasant exam for me in the year 2020. I found it pretty easy and understandable and comprehensible in the way that not only the questions were understandable because of all the practice from the LSAT prep tests, but rather the format and the way the exam was structured. It's still online, so it was a different experience, but a very pleasant one nonetheless. And the website was, as in the portal, examination portal, was very easy and student friendly for that fact. I could understand where I am, I could calculate when do I have to move between, I could see which questions I have attempted, which questions do I have to attempt, and the timer was there, and all of these things have a really, these things are really important from a student point of view, because when you're in an exam, you tend to get very anxious, and in that anxiety, you mess up a lot of things. But the LSAT India didn't allow that to happen. From LSAC, I found a very helpful book, The Next 10 Official LSAT Prep Tests. And these were actually the ones on the international forum. These were not just structured for the LSAT India. Although for LSAT India, we did have four free prep tests on their site on registration for the LSAT India exam. But also the international book, The Next 10 Official LSAT Prep Tests, that actually helped me a lot understand how on an international level this exam was being held and the difficulty of questions, the critical reasoning, the analogical reasoning part of it. Just the LSAT prep tests are not enough unless you're attempting them in the correct way, unless you're actually understanding as to how to attempt these tests. I guess that the most crucial thing is converting that LSAT India prep tests to your advantage, because everyone has those prep tests. You all are on the same level. So how do we take a serious advantage of all of them? So that's how you understand and interpret as to what the LSAT requires, which are basic tenets of reasoning, deductive logic, and language comprehension. My preparation strategy from the very beginning was timed tests. So the thing about all these law entrances is that although all of us can get full marks, given that we attempt the paper for a few minutes more or maybe another hour more, that's not the point. The point always is that whether we can perform in the heat of the moment and if we can arrive at the answer in very efficient manner. So I guess for that, what you have to do is, at least that's what I did. I did time tests a lot. I think that's what really differentiates LSAT India from all other tests, that it tests logic. And as we all know, logic is something which we all desperately need in the legal career. When we're making arguments in cases, we need to have a very clear thought of process and we need to know what we are going to speak. Otherwise, if you don't make sense, your case gets just disposed. In my 11th and 12th, I did my CBSE, which is the Central Board of Secondary Education, from here in Amity, Gurgaon. And I feel that since I started commerce and maths, I more have a business or a commercial point of view. So that's why I was immediately attracted to corporate law when I first came here. However, now that I'm seeing the diverse range of options, I'm also considering alternative dispute resolution and constitutional law for that fact. As in, these are just things that interest me as of now. So I really don't know how it'll go on further, but I think for now my interests are primarily these. I believe that law is something which is really fundamental to society in its most general sense, because you need rules and orders in order to regulate people. That's why we need, you know, we have positive and negative incentives all along the way. But if just taking the example of our own freedom struggle, we see Mahatma Gandhi, we see people like Dr. Bhimrao Ambedkar, Rajendra Prasad, and all of these were lawyers at the end of the day. They all had their own practices, they all came up and took the country forward. They took it to the next level. And this is not just India, as in this wasn't just a coincidence. It was also seen in, I think, the United States, where Abraham Lincoln himself was a lawyer. And these are people who really bring change in our world. So I think that what law means to me in a fundamental way is that it's simply something which regulates society. We all know that in all law entrances, we don't attempt all the questions. We're not supposed to. We're supposed to selectively read and choose what we're going to attempt. We don't have to be just the best. We have to simply give our own best. And for that, we need to understand as to how many questions we can attempt and how much time. For which, again, you need to at least read the paper in the first cursory glance. But in online, you can't do that. You can't just go question to question and try to remember which question was where. So I guess that in the times of COVID, the most important thing is that to keep giving tests online. And again, the reason which I say this is that if we practice ourselves online, if we tune our brains according to it, sure, we have been trained to do paper and pen since the past 12 years of our own school life. And we all have been doing all of this since a lot of time. And it's difficult to change, but I guess that it's difficult for all of us. So the ones who are really good at this, who are really good at changing themselves from an offline to an online mode, would really benefit. So giving a computer-based test is a very different experience, for which you should always practice on the computer. So I guess that's my only advice.